I mean, you know, I just like I always say, you know, I try to do, you know, my part that the team get the W that night, you know.
Now a free agent, Dennis Schroder has made it clear that he wants to play for his country, Germany, in the upcoming 2021 Olympics in Tokyo, Japan. However, whether he gets his wish or not is not confirmed yet, but he's already hard at work preparing for the next season of the NBA. He's back in the gym and he's working out at the Lakers facility in El Segundo. In this video, we're going to talk about the NBA star Dennis Schroder and where his career might be headed in the near future. But before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss any of the new videos we post. The point guard is bound to have an interesting offseason as an NBA free agent. He's aiming high to land a new contract, and as of June 2021, he has already turned down a lucrative contract extension offered by the Los Angeles Lakers. The New York Times reported a few months ago that Schroder was reportedly offered a four-year extension with the $80 million range by the Lakers, but he's turned it down. It was shocking for a lot of people to know that he turned down that amount of money, and that is one of the reasons why the Lakers shopped him ahead of the NBA trade deadline. It seems that the Lakers wasn't exactly what Schroder was looking for. He wants a more significant role as a lead playmaker. However, that's not going to happen anytime soon, considering that LeBron James is still in the team and is still leading it. However, there are a few insights on where he might end up, and fans could soon see him playing for the New York Knicks, Chicago Bulls, or the Toronto Raptors. Schroder is the biggest free agent from the Los Angeles Lakers this season. The team doesn't have much wiggle room when it comes to adding outside free agents, so their choices are either to retain him or flip him in a sign-in and trade to recoup some assets. Rumor has it that he was looking for a contract that's worth from $100 to $120 million, and that's substantially more than what the Lakers were offering. It was pretty clear he turned down what the doctor offered, because he thought he could get more elsewhere. At $100 million for 4 years, Schroder is earning $25 million a year, and according to some experts, the Lakers, or any other team for that matter, would find it difficult to pay him after his performance last season. He averaged 15.4 points and 4.8 assists per game, but he struggled with his shot from the three and was inconsistent on both ends. His decision not to remain with the Lakers was quite the opposite of what was reported in April of this year, and he wanted to re-sign with the Lakers to give fans a championship next year. He was the team's most prized acquisition during the offseason, and he bounced back in Game 6 when he scored 20 points with 3 rebounds and 3 assists. He looked more like the player the team saw during the 2020-21 season as he injected energy into a lifeless Staples Center. He said that he believes that he will be more comfortable if he is given a second year with the Lakers, but he's not using that as an excuse. He said that he just wanted to figure everybody out and be more comfortable with the people around him. The Lakers and Schroder can reach a deal on an extension up until the 1st of August, but the Lakers can't offer more than $84 million they previously put on the table. As of now, Schroder is busy preparing for the next season, and he's been documenting the whole preseason workout on his personal YouTube channel. One famous NBA star was even caught running into Schroder at the UCLA Health Training Center. Anthony Davis said that his injuries feel better and that all he needed was time to fully heal from his injuries. He even told Schroder that he's been working out every day, and that seems to be a good indication of his level of motivation during summer. Experts and fans alike have been talking about the reasons that the Lakers should re-sign Dennis Schroder and the reasons why they shouldn't. Even before the LA Lakers failed to defend their crown, contract discussions have been ongoing all year. He, just like most players in the Lakers, failed to step up when Anthony Davis was hampered by an injury. Some experts say that Schroder is only 27, and there's a theory that his best years are still ahead of him. He could still develop and become one of the best two-way guards, just like how he has worked his way up to becoming a starting point guard for various teams of championship caliber. However, others say he's inconsistent, and that doesn't warrant a long-term stay with the Lakers. While he does manage to put on a stellar performance every now and then, those have been few and far between. Over the 61 games he has played this season, he scored single digits in 10 of them and was only able to dish out 8 assists in 14 of them. Despite his prime year still being ahead of him, the Lakers have an option to bring in someone who is more consistent and reliable on the floor. However, even if the Lakers allow Schroder to leave the franchise in the summer, they won't be able to sign another point guard of his caliber. Why? Because they simply don't have the cap space anymore. Their only other option is to increase their cap by re-signing him, since they have his bird rights. It seems nonsensical to let Schroder go, and there should be considerable interest in him should they not offer him the figures that he wants. Another group of people, on the other hand, say that Schroder is not worth his contract demands. Since they let him walk, it indicates that the Lakers don't believe he is worthy of the figure he is demanding. He hasn't exactly been outstanding this season and has also had a dismal postseason. The team may focus on developing their younger talent and offload one of their contracted players to try and bring in a point guard. Another alternative is to arrange a sign and trade deal with other teams for veteran players. Schroder has ability on both ends of the floor, and there are a few point guards in the league that can defend and score. He's got a lot of energy to bring to the LA Lakers, and he's impressed both LeBron James and Frank Vogel on the side of the court this year. While he's not the greatest of a defender, his stats fail to highlight what he brings to the team. With him and Alex Caruso, the Lakers have intelligent ball defenders, but despite his steady performance during the regular season, Schroder failed to show up and step up in the playoffs. Bar the 2017-2018 season, Schroder has played yearly in the postseason, yet this was his least efficient per 36 minutes. Schroder was born on the 15th of September of 1993 in Braunschweig, Germany, where he also grew up. His parents are Fatou Schroder and Axel Schroder, and Dennis also has two older step-siblings. His parents met while on vacation in Banjul, Gambia. Growing up as a black Muslim was no easy feat for Dennis. He went to a school where he was only one of two black students. He, along with his older brother Awa and older sister Che, faced many discriminatory behaviors while growing up. Luckily for Dennis, he didn't let the discrimination prevent him from doing what he wanted and achieving his dreams. After his father died, he became focused on basketball, and after school, that was the only thing he did. He started his basketball journey in his home country and his hometown, where he began his professional career playing for SG Braunschweig, a development team of the German basketball team Phantoms Braunschweig. After 3 years with the Phantoms, he decided to take a further step by declaring his intent to join the 2013 NBA draft, where he was picked by the Atlanta Hawks. He became an integral part of the team and was with the Hawks for 5 years. He then moved on to Oklahoma City Thunder. Aside from playing for the NBA, Schroder has also appeared for the German national basketball team. He's happily married to Ellen Ziolo Schroder. The couple first met in 2018, and the basketball player immediately fell for her. They got together in August of that year and didn't need a lot of time to realize that they felt something for each other. The couple's firstborn son is Dennis Malik Schroder Jr., who was born on the 19th of February of 2019. He was born just 5 months before his parents got married. The couple got married in 2019 in Germany in front of more than 350 people, although the ceremony was initially planned for only 50 people. The family of three soon added another member on the 3rd of August of 2020 when they welcomed a baby girl named Emalia Aliyah. Schroder has one of the most distinct hairstyles in the league, and that hairstyle has an interesting story behind it. It was Schroder's mother who asked him to get a haircut that people won't forget. You see, his mother Fatou happens to be a hairdresser, and she convinced him to dye his hair blonde. He didn't dye his whole head blonde, but he left a small patch above his left temple. To this day, it remains his signature look. What do you think will happen to Schroder? Do you think he'll be winning any championships soon? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section. Stay tuned to this channel for more exciting videos, and we'll see you again next time.